We've already talked about the very unique relationships that various commodities and certain other asset classes have. And we're going to talk now about the dollar versus commodities. And John, this is an important and interesting correlation here. Specifically, how does this correlation work?
Well, there is an inverse correlation between the dollar index, or the dollar, and commodity prices. In other words, when the dollar, the U.S. dollar is rising, this normally has a depressing effect on commodity prices. On the other hand, when the dollar is weakening, this has a tendency to push commodity prices.
So we're talking about orange juice, cotton, lumber, heating oil, gasoline, that kind of thing.
Absolutely. And just as another example, grain markets, for example, they're very export sensitive. So when the dollar is strong, it diminishes demand for grain markets. When the dollar is weak, it increases export demand.
For starters, let's take a look, and we're going to show you a chart here of the dollar index, and we're going to look at what the dollar has done over the last 10 years. Here's the chart. Give us an idea of what this shows you.
Ted, the whole point of this chart is simply to show that the dollar index has been basically in a trading range for the last 10 years. By the way, the dollar index is the dollar against a basket of overseas currencies. This is my favorite way of studying the dollar. The whole point of the chart is that you'll see that we have been, well, the dollar has been rallying since roughly 1995. However, it has reached the upper end of the chart. As you can see, that is a long-term resistance area. Those were the highs that were set back in 1989.
So the parameters here are at the lower end 80 and the upper end 104.
Right. Okay. And purely from a technical standpoint, that simply means that the U.S. dollar has moved into a significant resistance area, and it is showing some early signs of breaking down. And that's very significant, because if the dollar does start to weaken from this level, and we suspect that's the case, that could be a positive influence on commodities.
You led yourself beautifully into the next chart, and this is where you are the king and the dean, Intermarket. We're going to show you two charts here, the dollar index on top, the CRB index on bottom. What's the relationship?
Okay, we're going to show the inverse relationship.
And we should point out the CRB index, for those who don't know, is the Commodity Research Bureau index. It is a basket of commodities. There are others. We'll talk more about those a little later, but what's the deal here?
Ted, the whole point of this chart is simply to show the inverse relationship. The chart along the top, that is the dollar index going back about 5 years. The chart along the bottom is the CRB index. And you'll notice there are two, really, you can almost divide this chart in half. To the left of the chart, roughly through 1994 and 1995, if you look at the top of the chart, you'll notice that the U.S. dollar was falling. Now, the intermarket relationship suggests that commodities should be rising during that period of time. And, of course, you can see that was clearly the case. Now, the dollar started to turn up in 1995. There was a little bit of a lag time there. But you'll notice from the beginning of 1996 into this year, 1999, you notice the dollar was moving up. That should create downward pressure on commodities. And sure enough, you can see that commodity prices have been dropping ever since then. So in this particular chart, it shows that when the dollar was weak, this was bullish for commodities. Up until recently, the strong dollar was bearish for commodities. And just to back up, Ted, if the dollar is beginning to weaken here, then that would give a boost to commodities.
Next chart, same message, just a little different way of showing it to you. This is what we call an overlay.
Yeah, so this is probably my favorite way of looking at these intermarket relationships. Computers allow you to overlay these charts, and you can see the relationships much more clearly. And you can just simply see here to the left of the chart, the bar chart there, for example, is the dollar index, the line chart, that is the CRB. But you can see it a lot more clearly that, generally speaking, when the dollar is falling, which it was to the left of the chart, that creates upward pressure on commodities. However, when the dollar has been moving up for the last couple of years, it creates downward pressure. If you look to the bottom right there, Ted, you'll notice that commodity prices during the first half of 1999 have been kind of moving sideways a little bit, showing some signs of bottoming activity. However, the dollar has been strong during that period of time. If the dollar is beginning to weaken here, and it looks like it's doing that, that could give a boost to these commodity prices, and that's what this chart is designed to show.
Next chart, and we want to make it clear, you're not a clairvoyant. You're not really doing predictions, but you can do probability. If past is prelude, you can look at what went on before and say that could happen again. And to that end, what is this chart? The dollar index again and the CRB index.
Well, Ted, this is a shorter-term picture. You know, we're in the middle of 1999, so we kind of have to look at the current markets. As you're right, we're not trying to predict, but we're simply trying to show how these things do develop. The chart along the top is a daily bar chart of the dollar index. And as you can see, it is showing some signs of breaking down. We do, we analyze each chart separately. First of all, you can see that trend line there has been broken. The dollar index is trading at a three-month low. And we showed you earlier on the first chart that we were up against some long-term resistance. Now, the chart along the bottom is the CRB index. And you'll notice that starting in the spring of this year, 1999, that has been moving sideways in what appears to be a bottoming pattern. However, the strength in the dollar has been kind of keeping commodity prices under control. You'll notice to the far right of the chart there that the CRB index has started to jump over the summer. We think that is largely tied to this breakdown in the dollar. So what we're suggesting here is that if the dollar does continue to weaken, that greatly increases the odds that the CRB index may in fact be bottoming and may eventually break out of this bottoming pattern to the upside.
So in sum, when you look at the dollar and you look at commodities prices, what's the relationship?
They move in the opposite direction. And the point here, Ted, is if you're a commodity trader, for example, and you're trying to get a sense as to which way commodity prices are going, you have to be watching the dollar. If you're a dollar trader, it's a pretty good idea to be watching what the commodity markets are doing. It's a mistake to analyze them by themselves. But the bottom line is they normally move in the opposite direction.
All right. And if you're interested in bonds, you want to know what commodities are doing. In just a moment, we'll take a look at the unique relationship between commodities and bonds.
Let's recap the material that Ted and I just talked about. When we talk about the relationship between the dollar and commodity prices, the rule of thumb to remember is that they move in opposite directions. Therefore, a rising dollar is bad for commodity prices. However, a rising dollar is also good for bonds and stocks. A falling dollar is good for the CRB index and commodity prices. However, a falling dollar is bearish for bonds and stocks. So whether you're analyzing the stock market, the bond market, or the commodity markets, it's always a good idea to know what's happening in the U.S. dollar. In the next section, Ted and I will be examining another crucial intermarket link, and that is the link between commodity prices and bond prices.